A piece of the brand new Grandview Triangle is cracked, broken, and sinking.
KMBC 9's Dan Weinbaum is at the spot tonight to show us what's wrong. Dan?
Well, the problem is where 470 westbound turns into 435 westbound. A part of the right lane of that spot has sunk several inches right before it meets a bridge. It's had to be closed off until the repairs can be made.
After all the years of construction and detours and headaches, the giant interchange was finished. Now, Mother Nature is taking a shot at it.
We've had a lot of rain this year, so that's usually a good first guess.
Too much moisture underneath the roadbed appears to be the problem.
The fill seems to be settling away, causing the pavement to drop down and cause a sag in the road.
Warren Zeller is the MoDOT District Bridge Engineer. He walked us through some of the problems.
The cracks in the concrete, those aren't normal. So there is some kind of stress here that is causing the concrete to break up.
And it's dropped several inches, quite evident where the concrete has slipped away from the barrier. That's a good 6 to 8 inch difference. So the one lane has been blocked off for now, but drivers on the other lanes are bouncing around too as they cruise by the sinking spot at freeway speeds.
Yeah, it's noticeable even in the part that we have open to driving, so we'll want to fix this as soon as we can.
So what will happen next is the MoDOT geologist will be coming out to take samples of the ground underneath the roadbed, and then a temporary fix, what they call an asphalt wedge, basically asphalt, will be laid down on top to raise the roadbed up so traffic can drive over it. That's a temporary fix. That'll be there until they can figure out a permanent fix to this problem. We're live by the Grandview Triangle. Back to you in the studio.
Dan Weinbaum, thank you very much. The interchange construction was finished in December 2007 with a cost of $300 million.